This is a demonstration of the seam node. The seam node connects two faces with a tangent, new tangent surface. In this case, I have these two surfaces, which are defined by these two vector arrays. Here we have the rendering of a B-spline surface, and I have a seam node with a lot of parameters, and at the end I have here a fast rendering using the grid node. So I select the grids and say display the grids, so we see here the faces here, and I also can now say I want to display the seams as surfaces. I do this, it takes some seconds, and I see here now the surfaces, and I can hide the grids. So I have this, and I can look with the Zebra tool to see how good is the tangent constraint on these sides. So it works fine. We can look at the parameters. We can say we have here 3 degrees, 3 and 3. We have here on the opposite side a 2 and 4 degree surface, and we have here a surface 5 and 3, 3 and 5. It's always the same. So this information, okay. So now let's hide all the surfaces and show how to create such a surface. So I start, I use first a seam node. I take the seam node and I say I connect it with the output of the two faces here. And I say I want to visualize it. So, and now I have to execute it. It takes some seconds, and we have now the result. So what we see is these two edges here are connected by default. And that may be not the thing what I want, so I have to change the direction of the poles of one of these two ones. So I can try to play a little bit. So what I see here, this is what I want. I have flipped the U direction of the P face. And now I have here two parameters, tangent A and tangent B force. This is the influence of the tangent here in this direction. So I can change it. And we see the impact. So the rendering is not so fast, so I hide the object, and to get faster real-time computations, it's always a good idea to create here a grid. The calculation and the rendering of a grid is always faster than the rendering of the surface. So I use the grid, I calculated and I displayed. So what's now? Here we see the grid. So I can change the parameters a little bit to get a better impression of the surface. Okay, and now I have here the face. I hide it again. And I change here the tangent parameter, and we can see what will happen. So if I set it down to 0, I do not have a tangent constraint. I have a hard edge here, but when I start this, I get a soft tangent, and we see it once more in this picture. So there are this 6 possibility, and at least I have here a flex seam only. If I don't want only the connection between the faces, but the whole as a compound, or a single surface, I say seam only no. And now we see we have here one large surface. I can hide these ones. I will hide the grid 2, and now we see we have here the two starting surfaces connected, and there are no hard edges in them.